We have Christoph with us today, and we will be talking about PyTorch Lightning and how he has used this amazing open source framework in most of his Kaggle competitions, and he'll be sharing all his experiences with us. So Christoph, would you like to go ahead and introduce yourself?
Yeah, sure. So I'm Christoph. I'm a deep learning scientist at NVIDIA. And there I'm part of the so-called KGMON team, and we are like NVIDIA's own Kaggle Grandmasters team, whose main goal is to participate on Kaggle competitions.
Yeah.
Would you like to talk about like some of your problems which you really like and the use cases which you have solved using PyTorch Lightning?
Yeah, so most of the Kaggle competitions I join are deep learning focused. So ranging from computer vision over NLP, to using graph neural nets for predicting molecular properties or something in this direction. So a wide range of domains and problems to solve.
Oh, great. So if I were to ask you, like, how has PyTorch Lightning helped you in building your models? So I'm assuming, like, when you're doing your Kaggle competition, you must be building a lot of your own customized models and ensemble models, right? So compared to using bare PyTorch versus using PyTorch Lightning on top of it, how has it improved your entire time of building models, and how has it improved your ease of model building process?
I mean, for me, it's very important to come fast up to speed. So implement a very simple model as quick as possible, because then you can iterate on ideas. And Lightning makes it easier to already have like the boilerplate code on which you can try different ideas. And it's quite flexible. So I can reuse like 90% of my code base between Kaggle competitions. And that makes it really, really easy to use and really applicable to multiple competitions at the same time.
So what would be that biggest advantage?
For me, the biggest advantage is the ease how to switch between CPU, single GPU and multi GPU setups. Mm-hmm. Because if you would code that by yourself, it's a lot of effort and quite some code. And with Lightning, it's basically just one flag in your trainer to switch between those different environments. And it makes it, yeah, really, really handy for me. I already start on a single GPU, because most of the competitions you need a GPU anyway. And I start on a single GPU with quite a small model. And as soon as I have that one working and I have a solid validation setup also, then I scale up to multi-GPU, bigger machines, larger images or larger data. And that's quite important to scale, to have a scalable framework.
That is great. So even like as a data scientist, I really believe like programming language or the framework should be like so easy to use, where you're not thinking about the syntax, or you're not thinking about like writing dozens and dozens of code, but with the minimal amount of code, it does the job, right? And that gives me the flexibility to work on more use cases. That gives me the flexibility on iterating more models, and that way I would be able to be more effective on getting better models out, rather than thinking about like writing bunches and bunches of code. So another thing which I would also like to mention is that when I started using PyTorch Lightning, I realized that unlike most of the other wrapper functions, PyTorch Lightning doesn't require you to learn a new programming language or learn a new syntax. It's simply using the PyTorch itself. So that's why it makes it even the more easier for you to code everything out and train your models using PyTorch Lightning, because it feels like you're still using PyTorch, whereas everything is like wrapped under like sophisticated capsules. So yeah, definitely. So would you like to like just share one example where you had used and switched between like single GPUs versus multiple GPUs, just so that the audiences could understand and relate that what could be the use cases where they could do similar things?
Yeah, so a recent Kaggle competition, which we luckily also won, was about classifying landmarks on a large scale. So we had like 1.7 million images. And training, even with an 8 GPU setup at the end, took like 24 hours. And because of that, it doesn't make sense to start with that big of a setup. So you start small, you start with a portion of the data set, let's say like 100,000 images, resized to a small size. And then you iterate on your ideas. So you implement a very simple model on the small images. You get your setup working. At some point, like after 4 weeks, 5 weeks of being into the competition, then you try to scale up image sizes and also as soon as you scale up image sizes and the amount of training data, it takes forever if you use a single GPU. And there it's really handy to just like put one flag in Lightning and you can use 8 GPUs at the same time. And it's like a nearly linear scaling then if you use a data distributed parallel, which is also included in Lightning, so to say. You have like
you're just encouraging me to try more and more Kaggle competitions, really. I'm just super excited for this. So I had like one last question. I would probably want you to, give out some examples. What would be really great for someone who is a novice data scientist who's just like starting into the field of data science? What would be the best technique for them to, get their hands on into Kaggle? Like, how would they start with being getting into Kaggle? You're the Kaggle grandmaster. So what tips do you give for people who are just starting in Kaggle?
I personally would advise to directly start with a so-called real competition. So there are like playground competition for starters, but I would just skip those because the ongoing current competitions, there you have a more living discussion of ideas. So people share a lot of discussions about the problems. They share a lot of notebooks. Also using Lightning a lot recently. So also the Kaggle community realizes that Lightning really makes your life easier. So they share notebooks, how to tackle the problem. You can copy a lot of code and just like learn from examples while doing this competition. I would say that's the most efficient way to get into this domain.
And if someone were to see and learn from your code, where can they find, like, is, do you have like some public repositories on GitHub which people can refer to?
I normally tend to share my stuff on Kaggle as well in notebooks. That's like the easiest setup because there you can directly link the Kaggle data sets and then you have like everything in one place and you can have your discussion there and so on.
Christoph, like just before ending the day, I would surely want to know from you about like how NVIDIA has the KPIs around you having as a grandmaster and how are you getting paid for something which you just like love doing, right? Participating in Kaggle is probably everyone does it for learning and fun, and it's really amazing how NVIDIA is able to have like this entire team of Kaggle grandmasters. So could you like brief us about how does NVIDIA benefit from this, and like what was the motivation behind having this amazing Kaggle grandmaster team in NVIDIA?
It started with like Kaggle grandmasters getting more and more reputation in the data science world as the kind of elite for solving state-of-the-art problems. And NVIDIA realized that you have like different aspects that can benefit the company. So of course, one aspect would be to also work on NVIDIA's own use cases and to bring your expert knowledge into your own use cases. That's also part of my job. So we also collaborate with other teams within NVIDIA to help them looking at the use cases and helping there. But the main part of my job is to actually compete on machine learning competitions. Kaggle is, I would say, the biggest hosting platform, but we are not restricted to Kaggle. We can also, and we do also participate in other competitions. And the idea here is that we kind of power user of NVIDIA tools. So NVIDIA has a lot of tools themselves, and we are using those tools and provide feedback to our own software developers, kind of like a power user, because we, let's say, are really on the edge to state of the art, and we need like stuff that works and stuff that works like efficiently. And we also promote then the tool stack. So if we use like tools that are really, really good and people in the community see us using those tools, that of course had also a promotion aspects. Exactly. So there are a lot of points how we benefit NVIDIA.
That is great. Thank you. This was a great chat, and thank you so much, Christoph. I really wish to have more chats with you like this, and really getting to know how you've been so great in your field. And as a data scientist, it's such an inspiration for me. Even I wish to work more and more on GPU setups, and I've actually not been working on image a lot. So I really wish to touch that space as well. So I would be looking forward to your guidance through that.
Sure.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.